everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about work done by a variable force. And in this particular problem, we've been given the force function f of x equals sine of pi x. And this force function models a variable force that's done on a particle on the range negative 1 to 1. So basically, we're going to be using this formula here to calculate work. And what we're modeling is a variable force. We've got a particle that's moving along the x-axis, right? We've got a particle that's moving in this direction, and we've been asked to calculate work done on the particle between negative 1 and positive 1. So we need to calculate the amount of work done to move the particle this distance, right? And the force is variable. When we have like a constant force, we can easily use this work function here, because let's say that our force is like 4 and we have a distance we know is 2 from negative 1 to positive 1. So we can multiply force times distance and see that work is equal to 8 units of force, whatever it is, whether it's foot-pounds or something like that. But in this case, we have a variable force. The force done on the particle is modeled by the function sine of pi x. So the force might be stronger sometimes and weaker at other times, but the amount of force varies and is modeled by this force function here. So we need to calculate the force done to move the particle between negative 1 and positive 1. And the way we do that is by using this formula here for work. And the work function tells us, or this work formula tells us, that we can plug in our range a to b, right, negative 1 to positive 1. We can integrate on that range the force function, so sine of pi x with respect to x, of course, and integrating this on the range a to b will give us the amount of work that it requires to move the particle that distance from negative 1 to positive 1 when we've got a force function of sine of pi x. So really, this just becomes a simple integral problem. We know that the integral of sine of x is negative cosine of x, right? So we have negative cosine of pi x. We're going to have to use chain rule here. But because we have pi of x inside our sine function and not just simply x, we need to, when we integrate, divide by the derivative of pi x. Keep in mind that the derivative of pi x is simply pi, so we need to divide by pi, or that's the same as multiplying by 1 over pi, and then we are going to be evaluating this on the range negative 1 to positive 1. So we can simplify this work function, and we can say that it's going to be negative cosine of pi x divided by pi, so that's simplified, and then we'll evaluate on the range negative 1 to positive 1. So remember that when we're dealing with a definite integral here, we plug in the top number first, the upper limit, so we'll plug in 1, and we'll get negative cosine. When we plug in 1 for x, right, we'll get pi times 1, which of course is just going to be pi, and then we'll divide by pi, and then we will subtract what we get when we plug in the lower limit, or this bottom number here. So we'll plug in negative 1 for x, and we'll get negative cosine. Pi times negative 1 will give us a negative pi, so we'll plug that in there. And then, of course, that's all over pi. So now we can simplify this. We can either plug in cosine of pi and cosine of negative pi into our calculator, or we can use the unit circle. We know that cosine of pi is negative 1, so we end up with numerator here, a negative negative 1, which of course is just a positive 1. So positive 1 over pi. Notice here that we've got a negative and a negative, so that's going to become a positive there. And then cosine of negative pi, again we can use the unit circle. That's the same thing as cosine of pi, right? When we have our unit circle like this, right, for kicks here, the angle pi is right over here along the x-axis. So cosine of positive pi just means that we move in this direction and we arrive at this angle. Cosine of negative pi means we move in the opposite direction, by pi, and we still arrive at the same angle. So cosine of negative pi is negative 1. So we end up with negative 1 over pi. And of course, when we simplify this, we'll get 1 over pi minus 1 over pi, which we can see right away is just going to give us an answer of 0. So what this means is that the amount of work that it takes to move that particle is actually 0. And that's it. That's our final answer. That's how we find work when we're given a force function and a range on which we're moving the particle, in this case, negative 1 to positive 1. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!